prepare yourself for the ultimate voyage. Experience new heights of unforgettable adventure on Star Trek The Next Generation.
We're back in just about Bradshaw, and an unprecedented event demands more competition here this week. But right now, let's take you to the Slam of the Week.
And now, Milton Bradley Karate Fighter's Slam of the Week.
Is he gonna? No. He's backing him up like cornwood. Is that what he's gonna do?
Oh, no, here we go!
The man they call Vader must be watching this!
Five times!
Yeah. In stereo!
And a count of three is over.
Slam of the Week was brought to you by Milton Bradley Karate Fighters.
All right, Justin Moore now. Testing the skills once again of Justin Hawk Bradshaw. Unprecedented victory over Fat 2 and record-setting time, and now he's right back with it.
Well, the man wants more competition, McMahon.
I'm impressed with Justin Hawk Bradshaw. Scott Tamora not having a whole lot behind those punches, however. You can't say the same thing for this rugged Texan.
I can't decide if Bradshaw reminds me more of Stan Hansen or maybe more than the Gene Hackman character on The Unforgiven.
Well, I'm not so sure that Scott Tamora is going to forgive himself for signing on for this matchup. Look at that little pump handle. Scott Tamora! And if this keeps up, Scott Tamora is going to be branded like Gucci was, much like Fatu was, as a matter of fact, earlier here this week. By the way, ladies and gentlemen, next week, joining us in tag team action, the tournament continues. We've got the Body Donners, of course, against the Bushwhackers.
Yes, indeed, the single elimination tournament continues next week, and we'll see if the Bushwhackers can slow down the Body Donners.
I really like this, Justin.
Oh!
This guy is deliberate. That is devastating. Lariat again applied, much like it was for Fatu. And look at this. Knee right in his throat. Count of three. Justin Hawk Bradshaw. Very impressive. He's going to be a force to reckon with, no doubt about it. And there you see it. Tamora has been branded a big old JB brand. Who knows who's going to be branded next? Maybe a old billionaire Ted's going to be branded. Who knows? As we take you out a TV trivia.
TV trivia. Today's contestants are Billionaire Ted, the man who's trying to put the World Wrestling Federation out of business, and Candy. And the category is Papa's Quotes. Here we go. Question number one. Which sports personality suspended from Major League Baseball for tampering said, "The world has gotten along without Abraham Lincoln, John F. Kennedy, and Jesus Christ. Baseball can get along without me."
As Pete Rose.
Ooh, nice try, Billionaire Ted.
Yes, the correct answer is Billionaire Ted. Next question. Who made the racial comment? As for blacks, well, most of them are not really black anyway. They're brown. Well, aren't they? It's very seldom you see a really black.
Michael Jackson.
Yeah. That's funny, Billionaire Ted.
Right again. Next question. What often married person said, "Henry VIII didn't get divorced. He just had his wives' heads chopped off when he got tired of them." That's a good way to get rid of a woman. No alimony.
Yeah, well, that was my buddy O.J., yeah.
Shame on you, Billionaire Ted.
Yes, the correct answer is Billionaire Ted. By the way, Nacho Man, where's the huckster tonight?
Somebody help me, brother. I helped the lady handcuff me, and I can't get out. He's a little tied up right now. Yeah.
Okay, back to the question. Which carpetbagger said, "If you want a fish, go out and make a million and buy your own stream"?
George Steinbrenner. Oh, damn.
Are you staring, Billionaire Ted?
Candy, you are absolutely perfect so far.
Well, thank you.
Yeah, I'll say she is.
Oh, yeah!
And here's our final question. Who said, "I'm worth a couple of billion dollars and I feel poor"? I really do.
Rupert Murdoch. John Malone. Michael Milken.
Billionaire Ted?
Wow! enough. I mean, I own this network. I own this game show. Right now, I'm pulling the plug. I think I'm powerful now. Wait till I get my hands on Time Warner.